Hi, my name's Nate Bowersock. I'm a graduate student in the Department of Ecology at Montana State University. As you might be able to guess, I've always been quite fascinated with wildlife and the outdoors. Early in my undergrad career, I got the amazing opportunity to assist with research on the wolves and moose of Isle Royale in Michigan. From this experience led to me migrating west to the Greater Yellowstone ecosystem nearly 10 years ago now to study the wolves of Yellowstone. From my time studying wolves, I learned that wolves play an important role in helping keep balance between ungulates and local plant communities. However, I soon found out that wolves are not the only predator to help keep balance in an ecosystem. Bears, both black and grizzly, also help keep balance in an ecosystem. And in a study in the early 2000s in Yellowstone, found that bears accounted for 69% of all predator-related mortality of neonate elk calves, or newborn elk calves, compared to wolves that only accounted for 12%. Now, I became quite fascinated with bears, and especially their ability to be able to switch their diets according to the availability of resources on the landscape. And this is one of many reasons why I switched gears and started studying bears. Now, black bears are the most well-distributed bear species in North America and have been well-established in the GYE for hundreds of years. The GYE is one of the few places in the lower 48 where both black bears and grizzly bears coexist with one another. We know a lot about grizzly bears in this area due to their threatened status. However, we don't know nearly as much about black bears. What we do know about black bears is they are omnivores, and most people associate them with consuming diets mainly of vegetation and insects. However, most people don't realize that black bears are predators. That's right, folks. Black bears are predators, and they do hunt and kill prey. In ecosystems where multiple predators are present, black bears are usually the most efficient predator to consume neonate ungulates on the landscape, unless grizzly bears are present. Now, in 2014, I got the opportunity to lead a pilot study using GPS camera collars to document the daily behaviors and food selection of bears in Yellowstone. From our study, we were able to show that black bears were more day active than grizzly bears, but that both species ate quite a bit of vegetation. The biggest difference we saw between these two species was that black bears ate more insects, while grizzly bears ate more vertebrates. Now, these results were pretty consistent with other studies in the region and show that grizzly bears eat more energy-rich resources, which allow them to grow bigger and outcompete black bears. And this was intriguing to me because black bears are observed more often than grizzly bears on the northern range of Yellowstone. And this was interesting to me because if grizzly bears are able to eat more energy-rich resources, then how are there more black bears on the landscape? One hypothesis that came to mind is that maybe black bears are following resource waves. Resource waves are naturally occurring events when energy-rich resources become temporarily available on the landscape. For example, in Alaska, bears have been documented to follow the red wave, which is when the annual salmon spawning run is occurring and bears congregate around streams to consume an energy-rich resource that allows them to prepare for hibernation. Now, closer to home in the GYE, ungulates such as elk have been documented to follow the green wave, which is when green vegetation is at its peak foraging quality, but at low abundance on the landscape. By following resource waves, animals are able to better utilize the resources around them, which could allow them to survive longer on the landscape. Now, in 2016, I started my graduate study to look into ecological questions related to black bears on the northern range. My project has three main objectives. One, to determine if black bears are following the green wave. Two, to better understand the predatory behaviors of black bears towards neonate elk calves. And three, to document how many black bears and grizzly bears there are on the landscape. To conduct this study, we collared 8 black bears between 2017 and 2018 with standard GPS collars that took hourly locations of where the bears were going. By taking such fine-scale locational information, we could not only look at what the quality of resources that bears were consuming, but also what other resources they might be selecting for, such as are they selecting areas where elk are having their calves. And finally, my crew and I hiked across our study area to look for rub trees, which are naturally occurring trees that bears rub on a regular basis to potentially communicate with one another, but also is a great source of hair. So along with the barbed wire hair snares we set up on the landscape, allowed us to collect hair on a regular basis so we can conduct non-invasive DNA population analysis. From our study, we're hoping to document whether black bears are following the green wave. If we are able to determine if black bears are following the green wave, then this may be a way that we're showing black bears are able to utilize the resources around them more efficiently, which could give them a competitive edge to still compete with grizzly bears. We also want to determine whether black bears are opportunistically or actively seeking out elk calves, which will provide new information on the roles black bears play in the predation of elk calves. And finally, we hope to determine how many black bears and grizzly bears there really are on the northern range, but also how well they're distributed across this landscape so we can better understand how these two species coexist with one another. This study will hopefully answer questions that previously were unknown about black bears, and we hope to generate new questions to help us better understand this iconic species in Yellowstone. Thank you.